myself. I can make it up by myself.
Got a mansion, a condo, a cabin. I sleep in my Phantom. Dancing with the stars to the Star Spangled Banner. I change your channel, I change your pattern. I ring your Saturn. I'm your madam, she get and I shake the ladder. I make her take her, then gather and calculate the data. I listen up for the snakes or the baby rattle. I play the shadows, don't play no games. I straight get at them. I'm on a all day, like it's my favorite album.
I play the sound when the Cayman Islands dancer. If I don't get the car first, I have a temper tantrum. I innovative.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. We've got one of the better defenses in the NFL in action today. The Raiders are top 10 in defensive yards allowed, and they go up against the Chargers, who will need to find a way to move the football. With that, we'll send it over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. They've got the call in this Week 5 matchup.
All right, Larry, after an off-season of questions, football is back here in the East Bay at Oakland, California. Today, it's a matchup in the AFC West between the San Diego Chargers and the Oakland Raiders. For Brandon Oliver, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. Second down following the run. They go again with Oliver, and he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5. Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a 3rd and 5. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. Gets it to Benjamin. It's caught. Kiss him goodbye, Travis Benjamin. And all the way in. Touchdown, San Diego. Travis Benjamin, his second touchdown on the season. And the Chargers have taken a first quarter lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
If you draft a guy in the 6th round and he gives you a 1,000-yard season at some point, would you say he's good value?
That's good return on investment. He was the first Raiders guy to rush for 1,000 yards in 2015 since McFadden back in 2010.
Latavius Murray, remember the name.
Steps away to his left. And he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40. That one goes for 24 yards.
Obviously, a big play was needed. And you can see his eyes light up as he realized there's absolutely no one in front of him. And he takes off and goes a long way. Not only does he pick up a first down, but a big gain to boot.
And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. So Amari Cooper out of Northwestern High School in Miami making a nice play there.
And it's so funny that when I was going through the draft process when he came out of Alabama and was inquiring about him and his skills, they say it all began back in Miami. He really became a pro receiver at a young age because of his attention to detail and precision. But don't forget his athletic ability. That's what made that catch there.
And he did spend 1 year with Teddy Bridgewater as his quarterback there, so that helped back in high school. So the chains are on their sides. It's 1st and goal from the 6. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. It'll be a pickup of 4, and it brings up 2nd and goal. Now Carr throwing on second down. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone. Now, do you put it in your quarterback's hands again? That's the question here on third and goal. Now they'll run. Murray. Only a yard there, so it brings up fourth and goal. Can this defense hold them out? Here we go now. Fourth and goal from the two. They'll go for it. It's Carr. And that is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. Marvin Jones, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Raiders, they're within an extra point of tying this thing up. And they will line up now for the two-point try. Carr will look to throw. That is caught. And this play is not going to work. He stopped short of the goal line, and this will remain a 7-6 ball game.
So what do you think the mindset was there? You can tie it with a PAT here first half. Why go for the lead right now?
The old school mindset says if you have a better team, you just go ahead and continue to try and dominate. There's also a school of thought, if you don't think you're quite as good, you have to try and take advantage of opportunities. And finally, I just think this is analytics coming into the game. Someone saying the more you go for two, the better your chances are of actually getting them.
They run, it's Oliver. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run, not necessarily block very well. In this case, though, we saw two tight ends on the field, both of them with ability to block, and they ran the ball successfully behind that power set.
And a nice little pass and catch there on the corner route.
Set up very well by the receiver with a head and shoulder fake inside before he comes back downhill to his quarterback.
He's going to look deep down the field. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
You can feel the anguish all the way up here. It certainly looked like he had that one in the end zone, open, unable to hold on to it.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get three down to the 34-yard line. He's brought down that time by a couple of Raiders.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First-level defensive line, second-level linebackers, third-level defensive backs. On that run, that is what we call a first-level run, and it was stopped by a second-level player.
He's got his man. It's Williams. It goes as a gain of 9, and it moves the chains.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
And down inside the 15 he goes. 13 yards there on the pickup. Good enough for a San Diego first down.
For so many years, I was convinced it was a myth. You know, because you always hear about the smaller running back. Oh, he gets lost. You can't find him. And sometimes that's part of his genius. But it's true. You get behind big offensive linemen, the defensive line guys trying to find him, trying to peek around people to see him, and he gets lost. But this guy gets lost in a good way for his offense, picking up big yardage.
It's Oliver, and he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Call it a gain of a couple there as it'll leave him with a 2nd and just 3.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Here's Tannehill now on 2nd down. This will be caught at about the 5. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be 3rd down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Back now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's the Chargers here with a football. And they're driving, but they come up on a third and short here. And the Raiders call on a nickel set for third down. Out of the gun, Tannehill. And they're going to get to him, a sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Perry Riley in there to drop him for a 4-yard loss, and it'll be fourth down. They've been moving the ball well offensively, really getting into a groove. Last play, pass completion. Now, finally, the defense gets there.
And you have to find a way to disrupt their rhythm. Do you do it with coverage, or do you do it with pressure? They elected to go with pressure, and it was the right call.
So the drive takes them inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
And now Oakland ready to take the field. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run-pass mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe mix it up a little bit with play action and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there to swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. And some room to maneuver. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play.
Murray fighting, lost the football.
Wow, that ball is not free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. A run, it's Murray. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
He's going to flip one out here to his running back. 20! And all the way in! Touchdown, Oakland! A great play there! His first NFL reception goes for 6. And the Raiders have taken the lead. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Here's Ryan Tannehill and the Dolphin offense back out onto the field. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but they're losing. And I think as the captain of the offense, you probably always feel like you need to do more in that situation.
The best have always felt that way, and they won't settle for anything less. So right now, his goal is to increase what he's doing on the field, try to make sure his teammates come along with him, and he feels like if I do better, everyone will do better. And that's what we're seeing from him right now. Got to have a little extra determination.
Yeah, a little extra determination. He has thrown the touchdown pass. No interceptions for him personally to this point. Tannehill. Henry's got it. Out on the left side. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Third down now following the completed pass. From the gun, here's Tannehill. Surveying the field. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. And now a high kick here as they'll try to cover this one. Jones on the return. Call that a 44-yard punt, 5 on the return. And the Raiders will take possession. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. Second down, and now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
He's got a man complete. A big play there for the Raiders. 36 yards.
Every quarterback likes having a reliable target at tight end, and I think young quarterbacks especially, because they want to get the ball in their hands quickly. I think these two, Derek Carr and Clive Walford, that's a pretty good connection for years to come for Oakland.
Yeah, he started to come on strong end of his rookie year. Now the Raiders really hoping for that second-year jump out of Walford. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Oakland after this. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Wrigley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and 4 now.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. First carry here for Tywan Jones. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a 4th down. Field goal would have been a decent length of 55 yards. They keep the kicking unit on the sideline. They're going for it. They'll go with Jones. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on 4th down.
One of the hallmarks of their success this year, they've been fearless on 4th down. And they convert another one right here to move the chains.
Carr now on 1st down. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Into the red zone. It's Carr finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Latavius Murray, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Raiders add on to their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Brandon Oliver now on the return. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Here comes Ryan Tannehill now leading his offense back out there. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but bottom line, his team's losing. They got to fix something.
And it starts with him. He has to keep that little quarterback strut going right now to make sure this team sees him as confident. Continue to try and up his game, but just let them know, hey, if I'm around.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. On 1st and 10, Tannehill. He's got time in the pocket. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Here's Tannehill. Connects it to Roberts, right side. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Third and two, Tannehill. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Tannehill on first down. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
And Lambeau will put this one through, and the drive will wind up yielding three. So they're still down, but they are able to salvage three here heading into the lockers.
This is what you work on from the beginning of training camp. Heading into the half, put some points on the board. No matter what the score says at that point, you've accomplished what you set out to do.
The final shot here before half for Carr. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. So Larry apparently giving us the silent treatment all of a sudden, and we're going to skip ahead to quarter number three. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Chargers defense as they get ready to go again. They're losing here as we begin the third quarter, trying to stop this from being a bigger deficit.
And I used to play for a coach who always talked about getting the other team's attention. And in this case, they want to let them know that you're going to do the dictating from here on out, not the other way around.
Trying to impose their will as we start the third. And now they're in the hurry up. Tiff carrying the game now. Murray. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 10 there. And the Raiders are going to have a first down.
And that's a good sign right there as we start the third quarter. Because in the first half, not much space to run the football. And as we go into the half, we often think to ourselves, all right, what's the adjustment? What do they have to do? You know what a lot of the adjustments are? No adjustments. You know the game plan. They're working on it all week. Maybe a little tweak here or there, a little bit better blocking. And now you're establishing the running game. That's another nice run. And I have to tell you, some of the coaches that I played for, their philosophies were always different when they see a guy running the ball well. Some of them wanted to immediately go to play action and throw it now because it's wide open. While other coaches said, you know something? Until they stop him, that big boy's going to keep getting the football. And that might be the direction that they're going to go right now.
And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Clive Walford, his second touchdown on the season. And the Raiders add six to their lead.
And that's just another in a long line of passing touchdowns for him today. To say that he's been on fire would definitely be an understatement.
Carr will look to throw. And no, it falls incomplete. So the two-point conversion, no good. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in.
And Henry's hit. He lost the football. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But, hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
They begin the drive with a run by Murray. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. Give him 11 on the game there. And that'll be good for an Oakland first down.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game. We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Throw left side to the tight end, Walford. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. And as our graphic shows, sort of back to his old form, you requested a meeting with a tight end coach this week. What came from that?
Yeah, that's not normal because we usually talk to the offensive coordinator, defense coordinator. It's pretty simple stuff, but you're talking about a former tight end now coaching who've been to Pro Bowls and understood what it takes to get things done and get them done better. He's had bad games and had to bounce back. So I just asked him, what kind of advice did you give him? What do you do with him? I told him to relax. He's one of the best in the game. Let's go play. And it's worked out pretty well in this one. That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Shotgun now for Carr. Eluding the pressure right. Touchdown, Raiders!
He didn't originally want to run, but he didn't see anything in the passing game, so he scrambled, and wouldn't you know it, he scores a touchdown anyway. It's awfully nice to have a quarterback who can make things happen with his legs.
And it's up and good. San Diego getting set to go. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
It worked. I like it, though, because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Room here to run. And it's a fumble. And the Raiders pick it up. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Whenever I see a team turn it over on back-to-back drives, fumbles on their last two, I know one person's blood pressure who is starting to rise, and that's the head coach.
Absolutely. And when's it going to go down? When they stop fumbling?
When they stop fumbling and after he's assessed the game.
And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Latavius Murray with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And a forced fumble defensively leads to 6 points for the Raiders.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
And this will be a touchback. Last year would have come out to the 20. This year they'll move it out to the 25-yard line. And now San Diego getting set to go. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Here's Tannehill now on second down. He's got time. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and, of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Here's Tannehill. Caught left side, Williams. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they can do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
It'll be a pickup back now in the East Bay. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. They brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on third and three.
A good call.
Tannehill now to throw. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Now it's second and seven. Second down, here's Tannehill. It's complete right side to Benjamin. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
From the red zone now, Tannehill. Looking for someone to throw to. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. A gain of four on the play, and it'll be a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Throwing again is Tannehill. And this is hauled in by Williams for a Charger touchdown. Tyrell Williams, his second touchdown on the season. And the Chargers, they're able to cut into that deficit. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country.
Now, whistles and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And the hands team for the Raiders able to secure it. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
Carries piling up. It's Murray again. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Cameron Hayward in on the tackle. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out. I see an extra DB on the field now for San Diego.
Yeah, indeed. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five.
All right, here we go. Ready, baby. Alert. Alert.
They'll run it with Jones. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. It'll be a gain of 8 yards. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks.
I like the reasoning. It's too far for a field goal, and it's too short to really get a big field position edge on a punt. Let's go for it. And sure enough, it's the ground game that's able to convert for them on fourth down.
On first down, Murray. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a 2nd and 3.
I know that every now and then we get in those meetings with coaches, and you almost want to roll your eyes when they talk about staying on schedule when they're moving the football. But would you say a 7-yard run is ahead of schedule?
Fourth quarter with a lead, you love that, don't you?
No doubt about it, because staying on schedule, trying to get 4 downs on first down, they did that plus 3.
That is caught right at the 10-yard line. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it 1st and goal. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
We ready? Ready at 18. We're going on, baby, alert. I'm ready. Here we go.
They'll try to run it in with Murray. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
It's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box.
And that's going to be caught for a Raider touchdown. Marvin Jones with his 2nd touchdown of the game, 4th of the year. And the Raiders add on to their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And now San Diego getting set to go. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard, because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
On first down, it's Tannehill. And right side, Henry's got it. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the 2-minute warning. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. The throw on 2nd down is Tannehill. Connects it to Roberts, right side. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. They'll come out in the pistol.
380.
On 1st and 10, Tannehill. Benjamin with it over the middle. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. They give them 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. And they're going to speed things up here. Now it's Tannehill. And Roberts with it over the middle. A gain of 6 there on 1st. 2nd down now after the pass completion. To the air again, Tannehill. Roberts got it. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Again, Tannehill. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. Brandon Oliver, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Chargers are able to close the gap just a bit. And that'll cut the lead back now to 21.
So the drive winds up going 75 yards in seven plays. And it ends with a San Diego score. And the hands team for the Raiders able to secure it. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And the offense moving quickly to the line. Carr gonna throw here. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains. A 20th carry coming up now for Murray. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. A nice pickup of 14. And it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. And quickly, they get to the line. Shotgun now for Carr. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Marvin Jones, his third touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Raiders add 6 to their lead. So a little icing on the cake there before the clock hits all zeros.
What a way to finish things off. Exactly what you want. Not much time and a touchdown to put things away.
And he's going to be hit and taken down in the backfield. Just nowhere to run that time. And the try for two is snuffed out. And this will not work out. The Chargers able to recover. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that. Just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics will tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie.
Chains. Ow.
Caught up in my put your head on backwards, then skate off after engaging laughter about what just happened. Napkins get sent to mammies, is that too graphic? Catch you in traffic, you sitting dappy like stealing candy. My ceiling's absent, my wheels are massive, my friends assassins, all of us. Our mothers queens and our women dancers. My river's rapping, my fin is splashing, my gills are flapping. I bit some matches, then sip some and kiss the dragon.
I'm really rapping, no finger snapping, them packing. Y'all slipping, my swag is dripping, so here's a napkin. What's really happening, verbal attacking, I'm showing passion. Know what I mean, see, I'm the king like I'm from Akron. I'm going overboard, somebody call the captain. And when it come to getting checks, I always want the fat ones. I'm so I can sing to a chandelier. My flow a glass of spade and yours a candle.
Too many buttons. Not enough. These fucking the SWAT is coming. Shoulder, no shoulder shrugging. That's your nugget. Sticky like acupuncture and Magnus honey. Knock on the side door 3 times and have your money. Or get to stepping like Kappa stomping. I slap. I'm having lunch with Italian Sonny. Don't ask the subject. Lord, why you took rabbit from me? He say, don't ask me nothing. Too many bodies, too many bundles. Not enough. These bugging, I heard they stung you. It's gonna be trouble. We come through and catch you while you cuddle. Barrels like tunnels. Don't even mumble.
I'm back to falling. I'm in the back full of lonely. Pull on the scene and the queen playing past the truck. Ready turkey, spaghetti, and castor oil. That's. Turn your guillotine to a fashion show. In 4 minutes, I turn this into forensics in a foreign car with a foreign. It's long-winded, paper long, and you taking long. You just don't get it. Hung the phone up on Say Tony, want a song with me. Hotter than Mississippi, the summer of the 1950s. In a van full of some white. Get pulled over for swerving like high officer. When he asked me why I was swerving, I'm officer.
can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself.
Mansion, a condo, a cabin, I sleep in my phantom. Dancing with the stars to the Star Spangled Banner. I change your channel, I change your pattern. I ring your Saturn, I your madam. She get and I shake the ladder. I make her take her, then gather and calculate the data. I listen up for the snakes or the baby rattle. I play the shadows, don't play no games. I straight get at them. I'm on a all day, like it's my favorite album.
I play the sound when the Cayman Islands. Dancer. If I don't get the car first, I have a temper tantrum. I'm innovative, I demonstrated this, played it. I don't care if you owe me it. You need to pay me. I kiss your lady, then kiss the baby. Get situated, get keys off table and leave her. I really made it, get it made. Won't wrestle, cause I spatula all you action figures.
Tiny like a spider on a spud web. I got some on my thumbnail. I feed it to my girls, they say, yeah.
I'm doing this for an L. When I go, I'ma leave for the bell. I told you did like a Chevy. I want a Ferrari in yellow, just so I can match all my yellow. I've been a player since elementary. I got my balls in the penitentiary. I got a that hang several inches.
I can make it bounce by myself.
Flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist.